What's going on, guys? Today I'm gonna record a detox shopping program. It's a program that I have on my website where it tells you how, you know, how to cleanse your body and how to get rid of body fat while doing both at the same time. So I'm here at Whole Foods right now, as you can see. So here in Sugarland, I'm about to go in there, show y'all what you all can get, show you what I typically get, you know, when I'm, you know, on my detox program. Of course, I use it, it means my product. So I'm gonna show you what you all can get from water, vegetables, proteins, and whole grains and stuff like that. Anything that complements, you know, the detox program. So you don't necessarily have to shop at Whole Foods. It's just, you know, I just came here just to get a couple things. But, you know, you can go to HEB, Kroger's, whatever grocery store you have that has a lot of fruits and vegetables and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm going to go in there, you know, take y'all through basically an intro to the detox program, so that, you know, when you all, if you all do start my program, I want y'all to have, you know, something to look back on and say, okay, now that's cool to get. I can get that. Because it's basically based on what you can choose within the list that's in the program that's already provided. So let me go here and show y'all what, you know, detox program shopping looks like. All right, let's go. All right, guys, so I'm inside Whole Foods. So you should already know where I'm at right now. Here with all the fruits, vegetables, you know, stuff you see outside of the grocery store, the outside circumference of the grocery store. So basically all fruit, all vegetables are allowed in this, in my detox program. Let's see. You see all this fruit here. All this stuff is allowed on my program. See here, looking here is off limits. So, yeah. Looking here is off limits.
How you doing, sir?
Vegetables you need. Brussels sprouts. That's one thing I ain't eating, but it's whatever. Alright. So I actually made, you know, my own little recipe last night with these zucchini noodles. Would definitely recommend y'all to try it out. Also, this is probably what I'm gonna eat tonight. I'm gonna show y'all how I made it last night. Definitely, if y'all are on the go, get these trays right here. Guacamole, these fruit trays for sure. Definitely get those. All fruits are allowed as well, so don't be afraid to pick them up. Watermelon. Especially if you don't drink a lot of water throughout the day, get you some watermelon and just munch on it. Especially any fruit, because fruit has a lot of water in it, and the water that comes from it is typically natural. So y'all make sure y'all grab that if y'all want. So yeah. Let me see, what am I gonna pick up? Some avocados here. Definitely get those for fats. Get some blackberries, strawberries. Strawberries look good. Some blueberries. Alright. Grapes. Can't go wrong with grapes, y'all. Pick them up.
if y'all on the detox. Spinach, my favorite. The reason I choose, if you're making any type of salad, the reason I recommend spinach, kale, arugula before lettuce is because the darker the leaves, the better, the more nutrients you're gonna get. So I recommend you get spinach, any darker leaf vegetable. So y'all stick with spinach. If you want to get lettuce, I would just get romaine lettuce. That's another good one. And it tastes pretty good if you know how to use it. So, and you see lettuce, man. Lettuce doesn't really have much benefits. That's why I don't recommend it. But you can definitely get it, but I recommend y'all just get any darkened leaf green. All right, here we go. Man, I showed y'all the apples. I love apples. Definitely something, you know, I'm gonna get. Let's see. And then if y'all can check out some of these fruit juices, it's whole food, so they're pretty good. Now, let's move towards the protein. Bacon. Can you have bacon on this program? Absolutely you can. What I would tell you is make sure you're getting either turkey bacon or I can't remember. It was one particular bacon that's really, really good. I can't remember, but basically any bacon that's basically lean cut, like you see, uncured, sun cut, that's typically one that I would recommend. Of course, turkey bacon is on the list. Probably one of the healthiest you can get. So sausages, if you like sausages, I recommend getting low-fat Italian. You determine how spicy you want it and stuff like that. But that's probably the only sausage or link I would recommend you get. Hot dogs, yeah, you don't want to eat that, trust me. You don't want to get that. Let's keep going. Got some chicken here. Now with this, I recommend you just getting lean. You see all that skin on there? Unless if you're willing to take it out, I would just get any chicken legs or chicken drumsticks, you know, without the skin. So let's keep going.
Well, no, you don't get
them
right now, so we'll be good. Even
past that,
yes, sir.
You got this first chicken fries.
I'm still looking around for
this one, but I have all my orders. This one, all the way to the start of it. Oh, okay. I was about to say, I thought I'd say just one little ass pack for $22. You got it? But yeah. Actually, I need to pick up some chicken for my next video. I'm doing chicken three ways, so probably might get it here. We'll see. So yeah, definitely you can get lean chicken breast, obviously as you see here, boneless, skinless, fresh chicken, ground turkey. Doesn't really matter. Like I said, with these chicken that comes with the skin, if you want to take it off, go ahead. Wings, I mean, that's really going to be hard for you to take off, so I would mess with that, unless if you want to. Here we got veal. Never tried that, but if this is something, if it's something you're used to, by all means, go ahead. Veal, buffalo, I think I tried bison one time. It was pretty tough, but it was a pretty decent meat. Let's look for shit. Let me see. Now I'm getting the TV more. Let's see. Pretty lean. Nah, I want something pretty lean. Yeah, got a couple fat on it. Let me get this right here. next, then you don't know how to do it. Here you go. Here we go, all the meats that you need. The leaner the better, honestly. I can have, except for pork, I don't recommend pork. Well, that's because I don't eat pork. Any meats that you see here, you know, go ahead and get it. Except for the sausage, I'm going to touch that. But yeah, guys. Just keep it lean, honestly. Keep it lean. So, yeah. All right, let's move on. Y'all saw the protein. So basically, keep your proteins lean. Simple as that. Let's see. Nuts. If y'all like nuts, almonds, you know, are always going to be king. Doesn't matter, roasted, salted, doesn't really matter to me. Almonds, cashews, walnuts, basically any type of nuts, honestly. Pistachio, just go with what you like and what you're used to, you know. I wouldn't recommend getting any chocolate flavored almonds or anything like that. All that stuff is unnecessary. You're trying to cleanse your body of the things that are bad, so getting a chocolate covered almond is kind of detrimental and it doesn't make any sense. So yeah, let's see. Whole grains, quinoa is definitely something you can put in your detox. It's on my list. Any legumes, so if you don't know what legumes are, basically beans, lentils, and stuff like that. So, I've never had black lentils before. I'm curious to see that, to try that. Actually, why not? Why not? Great source of fiber and iron. Yeah, lentils are very good at it. Very good in terms of having iron. So yeah, I'm gonna try this out. See what I can make out of it. What else? Wild rice. Definitely something I recommend. If you're gonna eat any type of rice throughout this, throughout your detox, wild rice is really good. And it has a really great flavor. I've cooked with it before. Brown rice, definitely a must. I'm not a huge fan. I haven't been eating rice lately. I'm not a big rice guy like I used to be, but yeah, if you want to go for rice, brown rice, wild rice, and that's probably the only two I would recommend during when you're on my detox program. Okay, here we have the seasonings. I mean, really, there's no limit on it. Just pick whatever seasoning you like and run with it. Yeah, I'm gonna let y'all decide on that. So, let's see, keep it going. Now, stuff in a can, I don't recommend. The only way I would say it's okay is you have to wash it. Like, for instance, these cannellini beans, just put them in a, what's that thing called? Just put them in a bowl, rinse all that stuff out, because they put a bunch of bullshit in it. More salt than anything. Wash all that off and then you can use it, but I wouldn't recommend just using this straight out the can. That goes for any can. Sweet corn, sweet beans, any canned products. So yeah, y'all be careful with that. Let's keep it going. Condiments. Any type of mustard, ketchup, when you're eating vegetable, eating clean, like you're on this detox program, it's gonna be hard for you to sustain it if you don't know how to spice your food, how to cook your food. That's why I say on the spices, I'm letting y'all choose. Make sure you take advantage of your spices, because you will get bored, you know, eating clean, eating in a way that's gonna detoxify your body. Well, I want y'all to understand that it's okay to season your food. So make sure you do that. I am. So let's keep it going. Let's see, tuna, sardine, tuna. Not a big fan of tuna. Tuna, especially if it comes in a can, I typically don't recommend it unless if you get it from like the freshest, you know, store. I mean, Whole Foods, I've never tried Whole Foods, but I used to eat an abundance of it, you know, when I first started this lifestyle. But right now, I'm just not a big fan of anything in a can anymore, so. If y'all like it, go ahead, but I wouldn't mess with it. So let's keep it going. Ooh, look at these chips. Yeah, I'm tempted. Sauces. When it comes to sauces, I would recommend you keep it low calorie. Let me give you an example. Example I'm talking about. So this one has 3.558 carbs to protein. Well, I would recommend that you get something about 3 grams or lower in terms of fat, and get about 4 grams of fat. I mean, 4 grams of carbohydrates or lower. Proteins doesn't really matter. So if you can find, you know, a sauce like that or somewhere close in the ballpark, then you're good. Stock tomato paste. I don't see nothing wrong with it. Just make sure it's not too much sugar that's being added onto it. So yeah. Chicken stock, use it. If you know how to cook, go ahead and use it, you know? I like using it occasionally, but not every time. So, let's see, oils. Definitely, you know, take advantage of your oils. Extra virgin olive oil, coconut oil. Never seen almond oil before, but that's interesting. Peanut oil, I wouldn't do peanut oil. Let's see. Safflower, I heard this one is pretty good. Never tried that one. Grapeseed oil is pretty, it has a lot of benefits in it. A lot of antioxidants. So yeah. Olive oil, grapeseed oil, safflower seed oil, sun oil, sunflower oil, almond oil. Obviously, if I recommend almonds, then why wouldn't I recommend almond oil? So yeah, coconut oil as well. So yeah, y'all take advantage of that. So speaking of, what the hell is this apple cider vinegar talk on? A lot of people are telling me that it's supposed to help you lose weight, and I'm like, okay. First of all, how does this sipping, taking a shot of apple cider vinegar is gonna help you lose weight? You know, that makes no sense to me. Especially the people that do it are the ones that don't exercise, don't eat right, especially don't do shit, and expecting a little shot to help you lose weight. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Makes a whole lot of sense. Come on, people, let's wake up. Let's stop being lazy and get our ass to work. Make something happen instead of asking questions and stop trying to find shortcuts. It's early in the morning, y'all. I can't speak, but yeah. Why you trying to find shortcuts? Hey, apple cider vinegar. Yeah, right. If somebody ever come up to me, it was like, oh, can I lose weight off of drinking apple cider vinegar? I'm gonna just look at them like, okay, you just don't want to put in the work. No, which is fine, but you know. If you're gonna try to work with me, you better move around with all that. But so that's a story for another day. But let's see, popcorn. You know, I fuck with the popcorn. Oh yeah, popcorn is definitely on the detox for some. Yes, I'm gonna give y'all some. know, to a little snack. So popcorn is definitely, you know, approved in my detox program. Let's see, if I had to choose, my favorite would be anything kettle corn. I love kettle corn. Let's see. And not bad for 2 cups, it's not bad. 18 grams of carbs, 8 grams of fat. That's not bad. So yeah, I definitely recommend y'all get popcorn if y'all like popcorn. And also, just trying to help y'all, trying to see if there's like a low calorie chip. Cheddar puffs. This is interesting. 17 grams. I could eat this whole bag at once in like 2 minutes, honestly. Yeah. Let's keep it going. Let me see. Let me try to find one more bag of chips. But of course, you're only gonna get this from Whole Foods. Well, HEB and Kroger and all the other stores, they might have it. I'll just leave that alone. You're gonna have to sacrifice when you're on the detox. I'm gonna tell y'all that right now. Y'all gonna have to sacrifice. But when you're on the detox, let's get one thing straight. I'm only gonna recommend you do it probably maybe once. Once or twice, no more than 2 times per week, because who wants to be eating vegetables? Who wants to be eating clean, you know, throughout the whole week? I mean, that's gonna get boring and redundant. So I only recommend it maybe twice a week. So don't worry about that. Eggs. Of course, eggs is on there. You're gonna need some protein. Now, eggs has a lot of benefits, especially the yolk. A lot of people like to go egg whites, and like, that's kind of dumb. The yolk is where you're gonna get most of your benefits from. So I don't know why people wanna take it off. So eggs approved. Can you cook with butter? Yeah, but keep it to a minimum, unsalted butter. Yogurt is not allowed. Unfortunately, yogurt is not allowed on the detox program. I'm sorry, y'all. Sorry. No dairy, but no dairy, no milk, nothing. No, because dairy kind of slows down, you know, the detoxification process. So, no dairy, no cheese, no milk. So, if you're a big fan, you're gonna have to sacrifice. Especially if you like coffee, no creamer, none of that shit. No almond milk, none of that. So, say goodbye. All right, let's go. Let's talk about water. Let's talk about water. Let me see if they sell this drink. Energy drinks, you definitely gonna need it, because you're on a detox, you're gonna need some sort of electrolytes to help you get through the day. So I definitely recommend getting energy drinks. Not necessarily from here, but any zero calorie drink. That's Bang. If y'all know what Bang is, go ahead and look it up. It's probably one of the best drinks you can get. I drink it very often, so I definitely recommend y'all go check it out and get y'all some alkaline water. So the days that you're doing your detox, I only recommend you drink alkaline water. So what is alkaline water? Alkaline water is pH water. Basically, it's what it kind of like neutralizes, you know, your body from its acidic environment. So a lot of foods that we eat are very acidic. So what does that mean? It's very harmful for the production of your body, you know. cancer grows in an acidic environment. So when you drink, when you eat foods that are alkaline, which the vegetables and the stuff that I showed you earlier in this video, all the fruits and vegetables are all alkaline. Basically, it's made to kind of purify your body and get rid of all those acids that's in your body. So when you drink and eat alkaline foods, you know, you're keeping your body healthy, you're neutralizing, you're purifying it. So that's why I recommend, if you're on a detox, you have to complement it with the water that you drink too. So here you see Essentia. That's the one I definitely recommend. I've never tried this before. I'm pretty sure that's good. Essence, pH 10, anything higher than a 7.0 pH is pretty good. I drink this a lot, Evermore. Those two, the two main ones that I drink. If you drink anything else, I mean, as long as you have a high pH, I'm good. I'm good with it, so. So that's it in terms of water, honestly. Just keep it alkaline and it'll come work out for you. Electrolyte water, you're gonna need a lot of electrolytes because you're depriving yourself of carbs, so you're gonna need some boost and electrolytes help you get that. So moving on. So I already have a lot of stuff at home, so that's why you're not seeing me putting a lot of stuff in this cart. But yeah, I just needed a few things. Here are the juices. You know, as long as it's zero calorie, it's fine. And yeah, no oatmeal, y'all, no oatmeal. The only grains, like I recommend earlier, are from beans, legumes, brown rice, wild rice. That's probably it. No oats, none of that. Juices, make sure they're low calorie and you'll be fine. Let's keep going. No cereal, y'all. No cereal. If you're a cereal fan, I'm sorry. No cereal. Oh, definitely no sugar. No sugar. No sugar. No syrup. Man, I know this is the depressive part of this video. Yeah, no chocolate chips. Nothing like that. Nothing like that. Look, I understand y'all want to eat all that stuff, but just for those 1 or 2 days, you know, just sacrifice for me. No peanut butter. Well, peanut butter, hold on, talking about peanut butter. It'll be hard to use peanut butter in the detox program because it's mostly based upon, you know, fruits and vegetables and, you know, some whole grains. You can't use bread, so what's the purpose of peanut butter unless you just get a spoon and just, you know, eat it like that. I mean, you do what you do. Definitely no bread, so don't even ask. Definitely no bread. Let's see. Especially ran through the whole food store. It's crazy. Definitely no alcohol. Come on. Definitely no alcohol. Sorry, y'all. Now, when you get to your goal, hey, you can have all the alcohol you want. I don't give a damn. Alright, let me go to the other aisle. Now, when it comes to frozen foods, I typically don't recommend, especially in a detox program, definitely don't recommend none of that. Unless, the only thing I would say is cool is obviously frozen vegetables. Just toss them in the microwave, warm it up, and you'll get to go. Just to make it easier, but just be careful though. Some of it has a lot of unnecessary ingredients, so just make sure y'all read it. Get the asparagus, super green, you know, stuff like that. Y'all could pick whatever vegetables y'all want to include, but yeah, no pre-made packaged foods. That's definitely acidic because it's processed. On the detox days, on the other days, I mean, whatever goal you're trying to get, I mean, I'm pretty sure that'll be fine. Frozen fruit, y'all can definitely get that, make some bomb-ass smoothies. I'm also gonna post some more smoothies as well. No ice cream, y'all. No ice cream. No ice cream. Sorry. Sorry, but hey, look, like I said, y'all gonna thank me later. No bread, obviously. You know. I think that's basically it. I think I just actually went through a run now. You know, Whole Foods has their usual, you know, food bar. But yeah, basically a tour down the grocery store. Like I said, yeah, you don't have to come to Whole Foods. You can go, like I said, you can go to HEB, you can go to Kroger's, you can go to any grocery store that has, you know, some of the things that I showed you all today. So, you know, with that being said, I mean, that's really all that goes into the shopping for the detox program. I hope y'all got a good glimpse of what you can get, and I definitely recommend you try come shopping with one of your buddies or something like that, you know. So y'all can it makes it easier, you know, for you can do it with somebody. So I mean, that's basically it, y'all. Whatever. So I want to appreciate y'all for watching this video. Hopefully it was helpful for you, especially if you're on a detox program. Hopefully I gave you, you know, a good insight of what you can get, what you cannot get throughout this program. So thank y'all for watching. I'm probably going to edit this video and upload it today. So I want to thank y'all for watching, and thanks for the support. See you later.